Hi, today we're going to show you how to do a geophone survey with one of our geode systems. Before you head out, definitely double check the weather and make sure you have all your field equipment along with a charged battery and sunscreen and anything else you need. So here we have the gear that we need for doing a geode experiment. To start off is the actual geode itself. Then there's a network cable that connects it to the laptop. There is a hammer extension cable for the hammer triggers we have. There is a power cable for powering it up with alligator clips. There is our strike plate and sledgehammer. There is a network interface box that will connect our laptop to our geode. There is, as you can see, 25 geophones all on this, this hanger. And then we have our takeout cable. This is what's gonna connect our geodes to our geophones. For some added accessories, we have a battery to actually make sure this all runs, and a tape measure, umbrella to keep us from the sun, some earplugs. Striking the strike plate is gonna be really loud, so I wanna have that kind of protection, and some electrical tape and some flags to mark off the locations. Once you've determined your survey location, place down your measuring tape.
So then lay out the geophones at the interval you selected, in this case, again, 1 meter. Only ever use your hand to push the geophone in, and you want to make sure that you have good coupling between the ground and the spike there. So check and make sure that it feels well seated.
So next, you'll find your takeout cable, which is in its own box. We have a backpack over it. You'll find this end of the cable, and you'll just pull for the end of your geophone line. So because we're doing the 1 meter spacing, we actually have to bunch up the slack of the takeout cable next to each of the geophones. So you're gonna connect your takeout cable to each of your geophones at their set spacing. To do that, you're gonna take off the cap off the takeout cable and geophone end. To do that, just rock it back and forth to expose the banana connectors. So I will take this part off. And as you can see, there is a cupped side, an exposed side on the takeout cables, and the bananas will connect right across from each other. So like that. And then to help with dust, just put the two ends of the caps together. All right. Now that we've set up our geophone line, we're going to set up a desk space for the laptop and geode itself. And in order to do that, we're going to stack together the shipping boxes. So then we'll start hooking up the geode to each of its devices. To hook up the takeout cable, I will actually turn the bottom of it to get the cap off. And then this will have a key on the bottom, on the top, that's a lot wider than the rest of them, and that lines up with the top of the geode, like so. And then it's a bayonet, so I just twist to lock in place. I can feel it there. I'll do the same for the hammer extension cable. There is one side specific to it and also has a larger key that matches with the top. I will just connect that and do the same. And then we'll hook up the geode network cable. This one, to find the top, it's usually the smaller portion of it that lines up with the flat spot on the connector. And I just connect, match up the lugs and twist. Next, we're gonna connect our network interface device, which will connect our laptop to our geode. We'll take the other end of that network cable, find the same small little notch and match it with the flat spot on it, and just place it in and twist, and it's locked there. And then we're gonna connect the battery to the geode. And in order to do that, we'll take our alligator clip cable and connect it to this threaded port on the other side of the geode. And same deal here, there's a little tooth for how it lines upright, and I'm just gonna place that up and twist it in place. Next, I'm gonna connect our network interface box into our laptop. There is a dust cover where the Ethernet port will go into. And that's ready to go. So the last step after we have everything else connected is to connect to our battery. To do that, we'll take the red end for positive to the battery and the negative end. And then we'll also attach the charger for our laptop, which also has the same corresponding colors. So red for positive, black for negative. For here, we're using a marine deep cycle battery to ensure that we can actually perform the survey for a couple hours. The runtime will depend just based on temperature, environment, and how many shots you're taking with the geophones. So next, we're gonna connect our hammer trigger to our hammer. The hammer trigger looks like this. It's a little cylinder at the end of a cable. I'll just take off the Velcro and unspool it. And then to attach it to our sledgehammer, I'm gonna put it as close as possible towards the end of the hammer, but not directly on the hammer itself. And just take electrical tape and cinch it really tight on the sledgehammer. Just give it a good couple twirls around. And we're ready to go on that part. And then at the end of it, I'm going to tape the cable as well to keep it from tangling while someone's holding it. And then from there, you can connect your hammer to your hammer extension cable. There'll be two adjoining sides with matching keys. You just twist and lock it. But going between each geophone, it's actually worthwhile to disconnect it. That way you can unspool your cable without it tangling. Next, we're gonna start up our laptop to start the survey. So now that we have everything hooked together to start the geophone survey, we're going to switch the enable switch to the on position on the network interface box. As you can see, a blue light started flashing on the geode itself. That's telling us that it's ready to connect to the laptop. I'm going to flip the enable switch back to the center just so it doesn't take away from the battery. And then if the network interface box is having trouble activating the geode, you can just hit the test button on the side of the geode to accomplish the same. So over here on the laptop, I'm going to start up geometric seismic controller to start the survey. To get to this point, I put in the settings as dictated in the reference guide. And once I get to this window, that means that the geode is successfully talking to the laptop and we're ready to go for the survey. From here, we are going to do a stick test first to confirm that all our geophones are working. To do that, we'll tap next to the ground and confirm on the computer that we see the response.
Ready?
Yep. Good. Good. As you're going through with the stick test, you can also confirm to make sure that there is nothing producing any noise in the line. So for example, this one has a bunch of twigs over it. We're going to just clear those out and make sure that there is nothing touching our geophone, because anything rustling against the geophone will show up as noise.
So for this type of a survey, we use a sledgehammer to provide the seismic energy for the survey. And so you have this plate that you hammer down onto, and you want to make sure that it's nicely coupled to the ground, get like vegetation or rocks out of the way. Safety equipment is really important here. Anyone using a hammer, especially on a metal plate, should have earplugs in, probably also eye protection of some persuasion. You want to have the extra cord over your shoulder so that it's not getting tangled or down in there. You want to make sure you have nice strong footing. Don't have people with back problems doing this part of the job. And then when the sledgehammer comes down, you don't want it to bounce.
So now that we're ready to record data, we're going to update on the computer where the shot location is to correspond with where the hammer team is going to start hitting the ground. From there, the bottom of the screen will turn green and show armed. That is ready for a hammer strike. If I don't want it to accidentally turn on, I will use the one button to turn the bottom of the screen red to disarm the system. That way, if the people with the hammer accidentally trip or accidentally strike, it won't accidentally record anything. But when they get to their location, I have to double check and make sure the system is armed and ready to go when it's green again on the bottom of the screen. So now the hammer team is in position and I've set the computer ready to record the shot at the location they are. So I'll give them the go-ahead to go. And now over here on the screen, I can confirm that we record that shot and I'll tell them to go again until we're done taking shots at that location. So good to go. Good to go. So now that we're done collecting at that location, I'm going to disarm and tell the hammer team that they can move to the next location. While they're doing that, I'm updating on the computer the new location on the geofilm line.
So when you've collected all of your data and you're ready to leave the field, it's important to take just as good care with the instruments as you did setting them up. Also, make sure that you don't leave anything behind. So start with the geophones, because those are easy to lose, not so much in this field area, but a place with vegetation or bushes, you can leave them behind. So leave the cable out and start by disconnecting and removing the geophones first. First, do the end cap open and then rocking the banana plug, recap both sides. And then you can take the geophone out of the ground. So when we're packing up the geophones, we hang them by this ring from the rack here. And if any of the cables had to be unwound or came unwound accidentally, you want to coil them up in a nice circle again and use the Velcro to fix it before you put it onto the hanger.
Before I disconnect anything from our system, I'm going to actually disconnect everything from the battery first to make sure it's safe. So I will disconnect the charger for the laptop first, and then the geode itself. And then from there, we can disconnect all the other cables. So I'll take the takeout cable off and I'll put the cap back on. It will line up with the key towards the top, and then I just twist it from the base to lock it. And then I'll continue to disconnect all the rest of the cables. All right, so the last thing you're going to do as part of your cleanup is to put the takeout cable away. What you're going to do is you're going to find the box it originally came in and take the connector head and place it in the bottom. And then you're not gonna coil the cable. What you're gonna do is just feed the cable back into the box as if it were a climbing rope. This has affectionately been referred to as spaghettiing the cable, but you're just gonna take up the cable and let it sit as it wants to in the box.
Make sure you put everything back in the boxes the way you found them. And double check that there's nothing left in the field that you have missed, and then you're ready to load things up again.